Freezing rain making for very slick travel conditions this morning. We'll let you know when this rain will wrap up.
And a winter advisory is in effect with freezing rain. Coming up in a live report, we'll have the latest on road conditions and what you need to know before you go.
I'm Jason Maxwell in the Nissan Roadrunner, keeping you up to date on the road conditions. All that coming up next.
Coverage you can count on. This is Fox 2 News in the Morning.
Good morning, St. Louis. Welcome to Fox 2 News in the Morning. I'm Aisha Khan.
And I'm Jamie Travers. And it's February 10th. We have a freezing rain out there.
Yeah, that's been a story all morning long, yeah.
Unfortunately, it's freezing rain versus that more sleet snow mix. So freezing rain, very hazardous. It washes away the road treatment, and it's pretty significant here across the St. Louis metro and especially to the south and east. To the north, though, to the north of the I-70 corridor, we do have a more snow in the mix there as well. But you can see some pretty decent pockets of this freezing rain south of Valley Park in the Chesterfield area. Also, right overhead, right in downtown St. Louis. These pockets of precipitation moving toward the north and east, also north of Collinsville there. We have some significant rain and through the Belleville area. But to the south and east is where we really have some moderate to even heavy icing occurring right now in Nashville and Washington County over in Illinois. And this will be heading toward Marion and also will be clipping Clinton County as well. Now back to the west of the metro along I-70 heading toward central Missouri. Again, mainly freezing rain, could be mixing in with a little bit of sleet. The farther northern portions, though, of that precipitation band could be more snow north of Warrenton. The Warrenton area, you're dealing with that freezing rain as well. So that's what we have currently on radar. Temperatures well below that freezing mark. That's why this rain is freezing as it hits the surface, because we are definitely cold out there. So freezing rain and sleet through the morning hours. A little bit of snow to the north. Snow accumulation wise, north of St. Louis, though, again, maybe around an inch. For St. Louis, it looks like this is mainly going to be a freezing rain event. This afternoon, though, we'll have a break and we're going to see high temperatures in the mid 30s.
All right, Jamie, thank you. And we're going to go live back out to Jason Maxwell, who's been in the Roadrunner all morning long. And Jason, looks like you are stuck in some traffic there.
It's stuck in traffic as well as the salt truck right here. Asha, 64 eastbound coming up on Big Bend. As you can see, it's gridlock. Even the salt truck, we can't get by. I don't know what's going on, but if I would have to guess, I'm sure it's ice on the roads, because like I said, eastbound, westbound, it's just been a nightmare this morning. But as you can see, traffic is at a standstill right now near Big Bend Road, as well as the salt truck. So this right here should tell you, you know, if you don't need to head out this morning, just stay at home and just take it easy. I'm Jason Maxwell in the Nissan Roadrunner. Let's send it back to you guys.
All right, Jason, thank you. And of course, as you just heard Jamie say, we are in the middle of the freezing rain that is mixing in with a little bit of sleet. As you had heard Jason say, that means slick roads. Fox 2's Kelly Hoskins has been keeping a tab on the road conditions with MoDOT this morning, and she's joining us live from Town and Country with the latest. Good morning, Kelly.
Well, good morning, Aisha. We're here at the Missouri Department of Transportation. Recruits have been monitoring road conditions 24/7, and we have reports of multiple accidents. We've heard Jason mentioning those accidents all morning. Now, we're told that extra crews were called in last night to roll out to start hitting the streets, trying to make sure that those roads are ready for what is here in our area right now. As we mentioned, we have reports of numerous accidents, so if you can stay in, please do so. Then the Missouri Department of Transportation made sure enough staff would be on hand pre-treating those roads, bridges, and overpasses, and will work closely with the Missouri Highway Patrol and the National Weather Service, updating us on road conditions, and they are slick. Now, with the wintry mix expected to spread across the region very quickly this morning, slick roads are expected here, and here's what MoDOT officials had to say about this morning commute.
Our crews will be out all morning until this stops and warms up. It's supposed to warm up before noon today, but there'll still be a lot of slick conditions out there. If this freezing rain continues, it'll wash off our material, which will cause the roads to get slick again. So people need to be extremely cautious out there. Any folks that have to get out, give themselves plenty of room, plenty of stopping distance, whether it's us or another car in front of you, because like I said, when you try to stop, that's when things get a little hairy. You know, you'll start to slow down. All of a sudden, you'll be sliding instead of stopping like you expect to.
Now, if you do have to head out this morning, be sure to check those road conditions, and you can find out those conditions by downloading our news app. And be sure to be very careful on sidewalks and your driveways if you're heading out this morning. And it is cold outside, so be sure to bundle up. Once again, be very careful. Live in Town and Country, Kelly Hoskins, Fox 2 News.
So, Jamie, once again, wintry mix, mixing in with this ice.
Freezing rain, yes.
It's just, yeah. As you heard Jason, he said that, you know, it's just been a nightmare on the road.
I know, it has. He has not made it very far here in the past hour. And so if you can be inside, if you can stay home, if you don't have to venture out, I know that's not the case for everybody, but definitely don't, because we have slick conditions, freezing rain still falling, and we have a while before this is going to taper off. Let's go ahead and check out what we currently have on radar. This is our winterized radar. So you can see the purple whitish shade north through Litchfield, through our northern counties. That is snow, but to the south we have snow and sleet, and then eventually freezing rain here from St. Louis and points south. We have even some decent, I'm taking off the winter layer so you can just see where the heaviest precipitation is falling. This shows it a little bit better. You can see all those pockets of frozen precipitation moving toward the north and east. Again, don't be fooled. This is all frozen precipitation. I just took off that winterized radar. South of Carlisle through southern Clinton County, also through Washington County into the Nashville area, and east into Marion and Jefferson counties. We have substantial freezing rain falling there, moving toward the north and east towards Salem, and then back to the west of the metro along I-64 and I-70 westbound into central Missouri. If you plan to travel that way, again, very hazardous conditions through Warrenton along I-70. There we have a good pocket of a freezing rain moving toward the north and east. What I'm anticipating through the morning hours, everything since temperatures are below freezing, the rain that falls is going to stick. Bridges, overpasses, sidewalks, driveways all also becoming very slick in addition to our major highways, as we've seen with Jason all morning long. So even by 9:30, still looks like we're below freezing. That freezing, we hit that freezing mark around the lunch hour, maybe even a little bit above. Hopefully we will see a change over to some liquid precipitation later on, but we're going to continue to see slick conditions through about noon, even maybe a little bit later than that. Then this afternoon, temps are going to climb into the mid-30s, so that's good for us. We'll have a break in the precipitation. Then overnight tonight into tomorrow, another round of precip. Now temperatures are marginal. St. Louis, we're staying with 33 degrees for the overnight hours. So it looks like St. Louis and the morning commute right now is looking like it will be okay. But to the north, we could have that icy mix again. So if you do travel northward for your morning commute, you could once again be dealing with slick conditions. So we're keeping a close eye on things for tomorrow. But currently we have very icy conditions here in the metro. 28 in St. Louis, Washington 30 in Cuba, 28 in Greenville. At Lambert, we feel like 21. That wind's out of the east southeast at 7 miles an hour. That wider view from space, even once we get past this frozen precipitation this morning, as you just saw, we have another round tomorrow morning, and even through Tuesday morning, we're going to be dealing with rain. So what I'm anticipating is this system's going to lift off to the east, and then eventually this cold front is going to come through. But tonight into tomorrow morning, we're going to see rain, mainly liquid, but you can see where we could have some of that icing, especially across northeast Missouri and west central Illinois. For the metro, though, we're going with liquid for now. That could change, though. Then throughout tomorrow afternoon, everyone seeing liquid precipitation as temperatures climb to the low 40s. Monday night into Tuesday morning, we'll continue to see some rain. It should stay liquid, though, through Tuesday morning. Once we get past tomorrow morning's potential mix to the north, I think we're done with the ice. So for us today, 36 degrees. Again, don't go out if you don't have to. Tonight, 33 degrees. Rain showers overnight into tomorrow morning. A mix, though, to the north. Your extended forecast, rain through Tuesday morning. Tuesday, breezy and cooler. And then we have another system Thursday night and Friday. So a pretty active weather pattern. Out of your work week, Wednesday is the day I think you can leave the umbrella at home. Otherwise, have that handy. And temperatures are going to be, for the most part, above normal for most of the week, but then they drop down for the weekend.
Yeah, pretty up and down, crazy weather pattern.
Yes, and this freezing rain, again,
very hazardous travel right now.
Yeah, so stay at home if you can. And of course, don't forget to stay on top of the changing weather conditions just by going onto our Fox 2 Now app. You can check road conditions, especially for tomorrow morning's commute. Plus, you can see school and business closings as well as our live weather radar. Just search for the Fox 2 Now app in your app store. Now, going back out live to Jason Maxwell, who's been riding around in the Nissan Rogue Runner, has not been able to get very far there on 64 eastbound as you are sitting in a gridlock there.
Asha, I tell you what, it's been one of those mornings right now. Let me go ahead and pull back just a little bit more. You can see that to your left of the screen. That's a salt truck. He's been sitting there, he told me, for about 20 or 30 minutes. 64 eastbound near Big Bend. Guys, this right here tells the story how this morning's been. It's been horrible. The roads are definitely slick. I don't know what's going on up there, but as you can see, traffic is definitely not moving here. I've been sitting here for some good 10 or 15 minutes at least, still trying to figure out what's going on up here on 64 eastbound near Big Bend. As you can see, if the salt truck, if he can't get by to treat the roads, you can tell it's going to be one of those mornings, where you just need to stay home. I'm Jason Maxwell in the Nissan Rogue Runner. Let's send it back to you.
Yeah, either stay home or if you're getting out there, pack a lot of patience. Now, just a reminder, if you happen to see or know of anyone who needs a warm place, call police right away to get them some help. There are also buses to pick people up and then take them to a Metro warming bus that'll be parked on 13th and Market Streets. From there, they will be able to get shuttles to the shelter, and that warming bus will be out there until about 7 p.m.
For eastbound at Big Bend from our Nissan Rogue Runner. As you can see here, mess on the roadways, even major roads and highways becoming very slick. Also be careful as you head out of sidewalks, driveways, very slick as well. Be careful out there. And it's been an interesting morning so far. We have freezing rain, but here's a look from our Patriot Sunrise rooftop camera. We still have precipitation falling here in Maryland Heights, and with below freezing temperatures at the surface and on the roads, all the rain falling is icing over those roadways. So very slick. If you can stay inside, stay home, definitely do so.
On to a Fox 2 follow-up this morning. The Illinois FedEx worker, first believed to have frozen to death earlier this month, actually died from a fall. 69-year-old William Murphy was found dead between two semi-trailers at the company's East Moline facility. The coroner for Rock Island County says ice could have caused his fall to happen, leading to a traumatic head injury. Now, Murphy does not believe that hypothermia played a part in Murphy's death. FedEx released a statement saying they are saddened and they are cooperating with that investigation. Well, as another round of wintry weather hits us locally here, a local animal rescue group is sounding off the alarm. They want people to protect their pets in the cold after a dog is found nearly frozen to death on the sidewalk. Fox 2's Michelle Medeiros shows us how the dog is recovering at Stray Rescue.
Well, the vet says Faust isn't out of the woods just yet, but she is making a few small signs of improvement. Now, this comes after a postal worker found her collapsed on a sidewalk yesterday. She wasn't moving. Workers rushed her over to Stray Rescue. The vet says her body temperature was so low that the thermometer wasn't able to read it. Right now, they're not sure what caused her to collapse and to go into a coma, but she is getting around-the-clock care. The vet says all dogs, even those that may seem like they're bred for colder weather, can be susceptible to problems caused by these frigid temps. She says it's also important to keep an eye on your pets around ice melt. It can aggravate their paws or make them sick if they ingest it.
If an animal has a snug doghouse that's lined with straw, you know, and has a flap to protect the door, oftentimes that meets the legal criteria for shelter. But it never hurts to call if you know, there's the absence of a doghouse and you fear that an animal is, you know, it was shivering and now it doesn't seem to be shivering. It's laying down in the snow or sleet. You know, that would be a good indication that I better just check up on this.
Now, if you'd like to help with Faust's medical bills, you can find a link to that story in this story on our website. That's fox2now.com. But Stray Rescue adds that they try to take in as many dogs as they can when it's this cold outside, but that also means that they need more people to foster and adopt.
Now, as you heard Michelle mention, to help with the medical expenses for this dog, you can find that story on the Fox2Now app as well for a link to donate. Coming up in your sports.
Cart as we speak. Now Robert Thomas drops it. A shot by Dunn. Rebound. He scores.
Turning home and keeping their winning streak going while holding down a playoff spot. And even with a great start to their play, it's a rough loss for the Tigers in Columbia.
And there's some live looks there at some of our area roadways where you can see cars on the highway all over the place. They are slipping and sliding because we have freezing rain. Temperatures and roads are well below freezing, so that rain is sticking, making for very hazardous travel. If you can stay home, do so this morning. We'll be right back. And if you're just now joining us, roads are a complete mess. We have freezing rain here along and south of the I-70 corridor in both Missouri and in Illinois. Some snow and sleet mixing in, though, north of the metro. But we have some significant icing going on, taking off that winterized radar where you can see where the heaviest pockets of freezing rain are right now. That's those shades of yellow and orange. All of this precipitation spreading to the north and east will end later on this morning.
All right, going back out live to Fox 2's Jason Maxwell, who's been riding around in the Nissan Rogue Runner. And Jason, you know, we've been telling people to stay at home while you are out there. However, you're sitting still on 64 eastbound. That's near Big Ben, correct?
You know what, Asha, I think the video right here speaks or tells the story. When a salt truck, when it can't get to its destination and clear the roads, you know, can you imagine what the roads are going to be like? Let's take you on 64 westbound near Big Bend. The road is completely shut down. People are getting out of their cars. They're talking. They're patient. You know, some people are patient. Had a chance to see a couple people talk, you know, outside the cars and stuff. Because now it's been some 30, 35 minutes since I've been on 64 westbound near Big Bend. But like I said, the roads are horrible. That's just it. I mean, the roads are just bad. They're slick. So just stay at home if you can. If you need to venture out, just give yourself just a little extra time this morning. I'm Jason Maxwell in the Nissan Roadrunner. Let's send it back to you.
For the latest highlights and stories, just click sports at fox2now.com.
Good morning, everybody. Well, they are red, red hot. This is the Blues team we all expected to see on a run here at the right time and essentially left for dead, but now holding down a playoff spot. They entered Saturday looking for a season-high fifth straight win. Saturday matinee against Nashville, and Patty Maroon says, let's give them a show. Maroon, Cody McLeod. Oh, he's taking the brunt of it. Squaring off early, those fellas. Blues picking up where they left off against the league's top team, coming off that win over the Tampa Bay Lightning. Vince Dunn scoring less than 5 minutes in. Dunn, seventh of the year. 1-0. Good guys. Later, it's my best versus your best. Vladimir Tarasenko, PK Subban. They tangle. Not good for number 91, but it's Vladdy with the last laugh. Tarasenko has been a key for this turnaround. All alone in the slot, he gets his 19th of the year. Blues led 2-0 after one period of play. In the second, it's the fourth line. After a couple of shots, Mackenzie McEachern. He's got it. Second career National Hockey League goal after the game. He signed a one-way, one-year contract extension. That made it a 3-1 Blues lead. And the major reason for this run, of course, just changed his name to Winnington. Jordan Bennington continuing to shine. Check out the effort there. Give him 29 saves as the Blues pick up another win. Bennington 9-1-1 in his last 11 starts. And for the team, it's five straight dubs. 3-2 was the final. And that's also back-to-back wins over two of the league's best teams. Blues and Preds doing it again later this afternoon from Nashville as the Blues have dug out of that early season hole.
I think our team really come together as a team, first of all. You know, the locker room is important. What goes on in the locker room and is just as important as on the ice a lot of times. So I think our team really gelled together and came together for one. And the other reason is the way we play. We all bought into, you know, putting the puck in deep and going to work in the offensive zone and just grinding teams down. That's what I feel we do. And we're doing a great job defending and we're getting really good goaltending.
College basketball now. Mizzou fading, entering having lost 7 of its last 9. They were also without Jeremiah Tillman Saturday. He needed emergency wisdom teeth surgery. Still a very winnable game versus Texas A&M. Aggies coming in with one conference win. Tigers, though, with only 2. First half, Tigers in transition. It's Devon Pickett, former Belleville East product, throwing it down. Tigers built a 12-point first half lead. Let's move to the second, shall we? Torrance Watson had a good game for the Tigers. The Whitfield alum with the triple there. He finished with 12. Tigers up 12. But it went downhill very fast. Aggies coming back. Wendell Mitchell, my goodness. Follow jam. Aggies would later take the lead. Jordan Geist had 12 for Mizzou. Knocks down a 3 from the corner. Mizzou up by 1. But A&M just fired away. They went on an 18-3 run. What in the world? Savion Flagg connecting from long distance. Tigers waving the flag. Got out of hand as the Aggies outscored Mizzou by 18 in the second half. Rough loss for the Tigers in Columbia, 68-59. A&M scored 21 points in the first half. They scored 47 in the second. Tigers falling to 11-11, 2-8 in the SEC. That's now 8 losses in their last 10. Next up, they host Arkansas on Tuesday. All right, to a winning team here. Illini hosting Rutgers, looking for their third straight Big Ten victory. Georgie Bashanishvili coming to play. The offensive board and the bucket, Illinois by 2 at that point. The Illini kept feeding Georgie inside, gives Illinois a 5-point advantage. Then late in regulation, Rutgers down 2, Ron Harper Jr. Tough shot, gets that to fall as the Scarlet Knights forced overtime at 86-all. In OT, the Illini go to who else? Georgie finished with a career-high 35, a new Illinois freshman single-game record as the Illini get that third straight win, 99-94. And that is your Sunday morning sports report. I'm Zach Choate. Enjoy the rest of your weekend, everybody.
All right, Nissan Rogue Runner's Jason Maxwell out there on 64 westbound, sitting in gridlock. And Jason, I'm understanding you may have a frustrated driver who's been talking with you.
You know what, Asha, this is the first time I've covered a lot of stories, but I've never covered a story on the interstate as I'm about to do right now. 64 westbound near Big Bend. I have a passenger here, a driver here. What happened this morning?
Well, I got on the highway, and it was okay until I got down here approaching Big Bend, and all the traffic's been backed up for about an hour. So I'm just waiting to get to work.
Now, you did something really, really nice just a while ago. What did you do?
Well, young lady had left her cell phone at work at home, and she wanted to call her job to tell them that she was going to be late. I think she works in the operating room.
And you're trying to get to work yourself, right?
Correct. I'm trying to get to my job. But they had told us that if we'd be a little late, it wouldn't matter.
Okay. Guys, I can tell you right now, 64 westbound near Big Bend, and I'm looking back and cars are just backing up, going the wrong way, trying to get off the road. But like I said, if you can tell by the MoDOT cameras and by my little Nissan Roadrunner camera here, the salt truck, it's been sitting here. It's been sitting in traffic a good hour plus right now. But like I said, we're going to stay on top of this and bring you more information about this crazy morning here in St. Louis involving the roads and everything like that. And we'll stay on top of this. Let's take a quick commercial break. We'll be back in a moment.
And you can see that we have very slick road conditions out there. We have freezing rain falling across the metro area, and it is creating for hazardous travel. We have tons of backups on our major highways. I know some of our coworkers having troubles getting in this morning because of that.
Yeah, welcome back to Fox 2 News in the Sunday morning. We have been keeping an eye on the roads for you and this wintry mix that we've been having. Are we doing closings first, or are we doing weather first? Okay, so take a look at these closings. We've just been getting some information about some of the churches that are closed. Some of them include in the Metro East area because of this treacherous weather. So that includes St. Paul's Lutheran Church in Troy, Christ to Trinity, United Church of Christ in Belleville, as well as New Christian Fellowship Church in Fairview Heights, Illinois. They're all closed this morning due to the icy conditions. Now, if you plan to take Metro Transit, heads up, they are experiencing significant delays also due to icy conditions. And at this time, all Metro bus routes are operating on snow routes. Metrolink has no delays at the moment. So, Jamie, as we were just talking earlier, this has just been a treacherous morning all over the place. Even our own Jason Maxwell stuck on the roads, and our assignment desk editors trying to get here on to work. They're stuck on the road.
Yeah, and we saw a Metro bus earlier spun around on the highway. So very slick conditions there. Here's our winterized radar, but it's very hard to pick out where those heavier pockets of precipitation are. So we're going to turn that layer off and just look at the rain. You can see south of Valley Park, we have more substantial rain over into the Lee May area. And zooming out just a little bit, you can see that that pocket there is actually headed toward St. Louis. We also have a significant freezing rain along I-70, just south of I-70 from Lake St. Louis over into the Warrenton area. And off to our east, through the Salem area, Marion County, we have a pocket of heavier rain. Now, Clinton, Washington counties over in Illinois, you've been seeing a decent amount of freezing rain, some of the heaviest that we've seen all morning there to the south and east of the metro. But now we have this pocket strengthening off to our west from Bowling Green and then down to the Danville area. So through Montgomery County, also Warren County, and then into western St. Charles counties, we have freezing rain again. Mainly freezing rain along and south of I-70. We have more sleet and snow mixing in to the north. Temperatures are below freezing, so that's why this rain freezing as it hits the surface, making for very hazardous travel. Again, lots of traffic backups. This will taper off later on this morning. Temps will climb to that freezing mark by noon, but I suspect by noon we'll still have some icy conditions on the road. So again, if you have to go out this morning, you're going to have to give yourself a lot of extra time. If you can stay home, definitely stay home. Hopefully by this afternoon, we'll be able to do some melting as highs climb into the mid-30s.
All right, Jamie, thank you. Well, of course, as you just heard Jamie talk, we are in the middle of the freezing rain that is mixing in with a little bit of sleet. And of course, that means slick roads out there. Fox 2's Kelly Hoskins is keeping tabs on road conditions with MoDOT this morning, and she is joining us live from Town and Country with the latest. Kelly?
Well, good morning, Aisha. We've been here at the Missouri Department of Transportation all morning monitoring those road conditions, and crews have been working 24/7, and Jason Maxwell has been mentioning those accidents. And we've also noticed an accident here at Interstate 55 and US 61 where there is an overturned truck. There's also one at 55 and 61, as we mentioned, in 44 and 141. So multiple accidents due to slick roads. So if you're headed out, be very careful. The Missouri Department of Transportation made sure enough staff would be on hand. Crews can pre-treat the roads and bridges and overpasses, but that area, in our area here, it's still coming down. And they will work closely with the Missouri Highway Patrol and the National Weather Service, updating on road conditions with the wintry mix expected to spread across the region this morning very quickly. As we mentioned, we are noticing numerous accidents. Now, MoDOT officials had something to say about your morning commute.
Our crews will be out all morning until this stops and warms up. It's supposed to warm up before noon today, but there'll still be a lot of slick conditions out there. If this freezing rain continues, it'll wash off our material, which will cause the roads to get slick again. So people need to be extremely cautious out there. Any folks that have to get out, give themselves plenty of room, plenty of stopping distance, whether it's us or another car in front of you, because like I said, when you try to stop, that's when things get a little hairy. You know, you'll start to slow down. All of a sudden, you'll be sliding instead of stopping like you expect to.
As we've been mentioning all morning, if you can stay indoors, please do so. But if you're headed out, be sure to check those road conditions by downloading our news app. Especially be careful on those untreated surfaces like your driveway and sidewalks because they are very slick. We will continue to monitor those road conditions for you here this morning at the Missouri Department of Transportation, and we will continue to update you live in Town and Country. Kelly Hoskins, Fox 2 News.
And our very own Jason Maxwell has been on the road, sitting still in the Nissan Roadrunner on 64 westbound. And Jason, what am I looking at here? This is all ice.
Yeah, all ice. You're looking at cars backed up on 64 westbound coming up on Big Bend. Guys, I have Andy Woods. He's a chaplain at Mercy Hospital. Mr. Woods, thank you so much for talking to me. Talk about this. What happened this morning?
I don't know. I mean, I guess they thought it was going to snow instead of all this ice. But the roads are bad.
Roads
everywhere.
Are...
My neighborhood was terrible.
Now, you said you were coming from South City.
South City.
And how long did it take you just to get here?
What time is it? I think about an hour now.
About an hour you've been sitting in traffic?
Oh, more, yeah. Well, I went really slow through the neighborhood. That moved. But slow. There was no traffic. It was ice. But on the highway, it just stopped here. I'm at the, right, where are we? Richmond Heights, right at the edge of Richmond Heights.
Right.
I just stopped. I don't know what's going on up there.
Yeah, yeah. So how does this make you feel? You're trying to get to work, right?
I am trying to get to work. My shift started at 7. I feel bad for the guy that's there now. But what can you do? You can't. There's nothing you can do, you know? I mean, there's a salt truck right there. He can't go either, so.
That's pretty bad when the salt truck is right in front of us, right?
Yeah, this early on Sunday morning, but... Right. It's not that much traffic, but it builds up after a while.
That is true.
I don't know. I guess, how do you anticipate?
That's true. That's
how
true.
They do it.
All right, guys, we're going to stay on top of this. And good example. You know, if you don't need to venture out this morning, you can see by my live shots right here. Just stay at home because it's going to be a messy commute this morning. I'm Jason Maxwell in the Nissan Roadrunner. Let's send it back to you.
And just listening to Jason take that deep breath, that sigh, you can just tell he's frustrated and so are the drivers. So I feel for you. And again, guys, we don't have to get out. Don't get out. And of course, don't forget to stay on top of the changing weather conditions. Just go to our Fox 2 Now app. You can check road conditions there, especially for tomorrow morning's commute and today's commute. Plus, you can see the school and business closings and even church closings, as well as our live weather radar. Just search for the Fox 2 Now app in your app store, Jamie. Yes, and here's a live look at 270 at Doherty Ferry, where you can see we have a jam, and it looks like that's a tractor trailer that has spun around there, and it's a completely perpendicular to the direction that the highway should be going in. So we do have that freezing rain still falling in the metro. We still have a ways to go before it starts to let up, and we are cold. Temps are in the 20s.
And as you've heard Jamie talking all morning, we are in the middle of freezing rain that is mixing in with a little bit of sleet, and that means slick roads. So people, please slow down. Fox 2's Kelly Hoskins has been keeping tabs on the road conditions all morning long, and she is live at MoDOT from Town and Country with the latest. Hey there, Kelly.
Well, good morning, Aisha. We're here at the Missouri Department of Transportation, where we've been monitoring those road conditions. And joining me is Bob Becker, District Maintenance Engineer, to talk about the latest and where do we stand right now.
We've got a lot of icy conditions out there because of the roads we've been out treating, but unfortunately the freezing rain has washed that off, and there are multiple accidents out there. We have had several of our vehicles involved in some of those minor accidents, and some slid off the road. So it is quite treacherous out there today in locations.
Is this what we expected? Should drivers, we're trying to advise drivers to stay home. Any advice for drivers this morning?
I mean, that's the biggest thing. If you don't have to go, stay, because like I said, there's a lot of spotty, icy conditions out there. And, you know, your car's not going to react like it normally would. If there's an accident in front of you and you try to hit the brakes, you're going to start sliding into somebody else and cause more problems.
And how many crews do you have out there, and what are you treating the roads with?
Like I said, we've got our full maintenance crews are out there today, 140 trucks with salt, our treated salt. So, I mean, these temperatures, it should work rather well once we get it out there, and pavement temperatures are coming up. They're about almost to freezing now, so they're raising, so that'll help our conditions also.
All right, thank you so much. As he's mentioned, a lot of weather-related accidents, so if you can stay indoors, please do so. Live in town and country, Kelly Hoskins, Fox 2 News.
Okay. All right, Jamie, I know we've been talking about slick roads all morning long. We are getting some more reports of accidents and cars going off the road. So this coming from the fire captain for the Sullivan Fire Department, who is currently in his fire truck, and he called our station to tell us that he is stuck on I-44 at the 233 mile marker. Apparently there's some 10 semi trucks that are flipped at the moment. So we're asking him. And there's an ambulance that's also wrecked. So we are getting information as it comes in into our newsroom. And of course, we're going to ask him if he can to maybe take a picture. Of course, do it carefully. But, you know, these are the emergency personnel out there trying to keep, you know, our drivers safe. And if they get into a wreck or if they're sliding off the roads, these guys are out there trying to help you. So please slow down or stay
at home. No one can drive on ice.
Right.
No,
just don't do it.
Yeah, even four-wheel drive doesn't help you in an ICS situation. And we've seen metro buses turned around. Salt trucks can't get to where they need to be because of the traffic, as Jason was showing us earlier on 64. So let's go ahead and check out what we have currently on Power Doppler, because we still have a ways to go before this precipitation is through. It came in from the southwest and it's moving toward the north and east. And the back edge of that precipitation extends all the way back through Jefferson County into northern St. Francis and St. Genevieve counties, and even back to the west through Sullivan and back into Rolla. It is spotty and it is light, but we still have frozen precipitation there. So everything we have on radar right now is freezing. We expected a little bit of snow to start, but it came down basically as freezing rain with a little bit of sleet here in the metro, and that's why conditions are so hazardous. Taking off that winter layer, it's a little bit easier to pick out the pockets of heavier precipitation. You can see that precipitation that I was showing you down through Jefferson County, moving into Monroe County, and then points to the north and east. And then we also have some heavy precipitation south of Bowling Green, north of Warrenton. Hopefully seeing maybe a little bit more snow in that area, but again, that's just hopefully. There, Salem through south of Carlisle, still seeing some decent precipitation there, and then that's that heavier band northwest of Warrenton. But along I-70, if you're heading west to Columbia today, you might want to rethink that because of this hazardous travel that we have currently going on. Temperatures, it's going to take a few hours before we get to that freezing mark. So future cast still showing some icing over the next few hours, tapering off later on this morning or early this afternoon. Temps climb to around that freezing mark around lunch hour, and then we should have a break. We're going to need that break, and then we're going to see additional precipitation move in overnight tonight into tomorrow. Now this is going to be a close call for St. Louis for the Monday morning commute. It does not look like it's going to be anything close to the extent of which we have out there right now, but we could see a little bit of freezing rain and maybe even some sleet mixing in north of the metro, where temperatures are going to be a little bit colder. Most of this, though, tomorrow morning falls as liquid. But again, look, St. Louis, we are right on the edge of that freezing line. So I'd say along and north of I-70 is where we have the potential for another batch of a wintry mix or freezing rain and sleet mixing in with liquid rain tomorrow morning. So we're not even going to be out of the woods even once this first round moves through. Then it will change over to all liquid precipitation for the rest of the day on Monday. Powers insurance camera, difficult to see what's going on out there because we still have precipitation falling. 28 at Lambert, feeling like 20. East wind at 8 miles an hour and pressures falling. Temps in other areas, look, we're all below that freezing mark. That's why everything's freezing when it hits the surface. And freezing rain is the toughest to travel in. It can be virtually impossible. So checking out that view from space, lots of clouds, that precipitation lifting to the north and east, even more of it though extending into south central and southwestern Missouri. So what we have for the rest of the morning, of course, this freezing rain, mainly freezing rain, maybe mixing with a little bit of sleet here or there, is going to taper off late this morning, early this afternoon. We'll have a break. Then we're going to have another round lift north, which I showed you just a little bit ago, where we could see that icy mix again just north of St. Louis along and north of I-70. That will taper off early in the morning, but we'll continue with some rounds of rain throughout Monday afternoon, Monday evening, even into Monday night and Tuesday morning. But the good news with that is that once we get past tomorrow morning, it looks like it's just going to be liquid precipitation. So this morning, snow, sleet, freezing rain, but freezing rain, that's the big one. Southeast wind 5 to 10, 32 by noon. This afternoon up to 36, cloudy and cold with a few showers. And then tonight, rain showers again with that wintry mix, freezing rain and sleet along and north of I-70. So our northern counties at risk for seeing icing again tomorrow. Now, lingering rain through Tuesday morning. Tuesday will be breezy. Wednesday, the one day where I think you'll be able to leave the umbrella at home, because then we have more rain chances for Thursday. That could change over to a mix for Friday. So that's the next time frame we're watching. After this, after today and tomorrow, we'll be watching the end of the work week. For now, the weekend, I've kept it dry, but it is going to be colder. Highs only in the 30s.
Freezing temperatures.
Yes.
All right, guys, I want to take you out to this live camera. This is at 44 at 100 near Gray Summit. That is westbound. And, you know, it's very hard to see what is happening, but I can tell at least on the roads. I mean, they're slick for sure, and they're icy, and there's, I believe, something's happening at the very top of the road there. I don't know if we're able to zoom in or not, but I can't tell if they're emergency personnel or if it's just cars just sitting in a line there. So this seems to be the theme, guys, everywhere, just about everywhere, especially on these main roads where, you know, they are slick, they are wet. And if you are driving, please slow down. You know, that's where drivers may end up losing control, then you end up in a ditch or you're hitting another car. So just be very, very careful. And your winter weather coverage continues right after this. All right, those windshield wipers are of the Nissan Rogue Runner. That's where our Jason Maxwell has been sitting patiently. I know, Jason, you're stuck on 64 westbound. What else is happening there? Not a whole lot, I bet.
64 westbound near Big Bend. Had heard a couple of, you know, people helping people out here. You know, one driver helped another driver. She left her cell phone at home, and she was able to call her job. But let me go ahead and take a look at, you can see the salt truck is here. It's been here for about an hour. Let's go ahead and take a look at camera two. You can see 64 backed up right now for miles, guys. I mean, it's just backed up galore. So if you're heading out here, you just might want to give yourself, A, either stay at home. Number two, just give yourself just a little extra time. But I can tell you right now, 64 westbound near Big Bend, it's completely shut down. So you might definitely want to just stay at home. I'm Jason Maxwell outside the Nissan Roadrunner. Let's send it back to you.
All right, Jason, thank you. All right, folks, if you are not staying at home and if you are instead planning to take Metro Transit, heads up, they are experiencing significant delays also due to icy conditions. And at this time, all Metro bus routes are operating on snow routes. Metrolink has no delays. And of course, don't forget to stay on top of the changing weather conditions. Just log on to our Fox 2 Now app. You can check road conditions, especially for tomorrow morning's commute. Plus, you can see school, church, and business closings, as well as our live weather radar. Just search the Fox 2 Now app in your app store. All right, a couple of tweets going out from the St. Louis County Police Department. They are saying that our officers are continuing to respond to multiple vehicle accidents across the area. There are trouble spots, including westbound 270 near Doherty Ferry, areas of I-55 and 255, and various other side roads. Of course, please avoid travel if possible, and put the hashtag STL weather.
And we still have plenty of precipitation left to go here before those temperatures climb above that freezing mark and this finally wraps up. But you can see everything we have on radar is falling. It's just a matter of what it's falling as. Here in St. Louis and Point South, that pink color, you can see that is freezing rain. To the north, that purplish color probably mixing in with a little bit of sleet. And then far north, more in the way of snow, which of course snow is a little bit easier to travel in than this freezing rain. Taking off that winterized radar where you can see where the heavier rain is falling, you can see it is still across the metro moving toward the north and east. And then back out to the west and northwest toward Bowling Green, we have some heavier precipitation and again a little bit more in the way of snow falling, where we could see up to about an inch of snow in our northern counties. But here in St. Louis, it looks like it's going to stay all ice.
We are under a winter advisory with icy conditions and multiple accidents reported. Coming up in a live report, we'll have the latest on those road conditions and what you need to know before you go.